It's AumSum time!
Are fruit juices unhealthy?
Duh, that's why I have chocolate milkshakes.
Compared to fruits, fruit juices are unhealthy as they are devoid of the fruit's fiber. Fruit's fibrous content slows down absorption of its fructose in bloodstream, preventing unnecessary spikes in our insulin. As juice doesn't have fiber, it results in fast absorption of the juice's fructose, causing sudden spikes in insulin. Over time, this can lead to type 2 diabetes. Now, one glass of orange juice contains at least 8 oranges. Instead of drinking juice, if we decide to eat oranges, it is impossible to eat more than 2 or 3. Thus, we consume more calories. Also, our brain doesn't get the same feeling of fullness on drinking that it gets on eating. We feel hungrier sooner, thus leading to overconsumption. Note that packaged fruit juices are definitely unhealthy as they are prepared by keeping fresh fruit juices in oxygen-depleted environments for a year, and chemicals are also added to enhance their flavor.
How do miracle fruits work?
By performing miracles!
Nah.
Oh.
Miracle fruit is a red berry, also known as Insepalum dulcificum. The fantastic quality about this berry is that after eating it, acidic foods which should be sour taste sweet. The secret behind this is a protein called miraculin, found in these fruits. However, experts aren't sure how miraculin actually works. But there are 3 popular theories. First theory states that miraculin temporarily suppresses sour taste receptors. Hence, when we eat acidic foods, they don't taste sour. Second theory states that miraculin rewires the sweet receptors such that they begin to identify acids as sugars, thus making sour foods taste sweet. Whereas third theory states that acids cause miraculin to change its shape, causing it to bind to the sweet receptors more strongly and thus making them overactivated, producing a sweet taste.
Is coffee good for health?
Nah. Cold coffee with whipped cream is the healthiest.
Oh, some.
Coffee definitely has some advantages associated with it. Coffee contains caffeine. It is a stimulant, which after consumption reduces tiredness and makes us feel more alert. Coffee is also a strong source of several powerful antioxidants. Some studies have shown that coffee is linked to reduced risk of a number of diseases like type 2 diabetes, Parkinson's, and Alzheimer's. But too much of something is never good for the body. Consuming too much coffee, that is, caffeine, can lead to anxiety and stress. In some extreme cases, it may also lead to heart palpitations and panic attacks. Lastly, caffeine present in coffee can be very addictive. If heavy coffee drinkers try to abstain from coffee for a few days, they may experience irritation, headaches, etc. Why do we love junk food?
Cause it looks cool, bro.
Nah. We love junk food because manufacturers design it to activate our brain's reward system. They create the perfect combination of salt, sugar, spices, etc., which excite our taste buds, thus activating our brain's reward system, making us feel good. Now, after this, when we eat regular food, as it doesn't activate the reward system, it feels less appealing. Besides this, if we compare these foods, the quantity of healthy food looks more, right? But surprisingly, they both contain the same number of calories.
What?
Yes. Now, since healthy food also contains fiber and water, they add up to the volume, thus filling our stomach. But as the junk food doesn't have enough water and fiber, it doesn't fill us. So we keep eating and thus end up consuming more calories, leading to obesity, diabetes, etc.